add-on desired. Welcome to Adapt Solutions News Analysis Program. Here, Taukate, Yas, and planning for the next. What are these? These are the names of cyclones. What is a cyclone? How this cyclone affects the society and geographically, economically, socially. All this impact will be there. And due to this, what is the amount of GDP that is losing? And what about the Disaster Management Act that is playing role in the implementation? And how far we have tried to mitigate these consequences due to the cyclone? And what are the measures we have taken over a period of time so that to easily avoid or the decrease the number of fatalities? In 1990s, there were like thousands of people has died because of the cyclone that has hit the Odisha coast. But now, even not in single number will be expected to be dead on the any cyclone affected. Hudhud was one of the biggest like a hit on the Vizag coast. And apart from that, there are many cyclones that are hitting the coastal areas. But these are not causing the as it was magnifying earlier. Now, what are the reasons for that? Indian Meteorological Department, along with the World Meteorological Organization, has tried to expect the cyclones much earlier, and they have developed a system of early warning system, evacuation system, so that it is reducing the number of fatalities and decrease the amount of economic impact of the cyclones. And then there are some significant observations. The significant drop was on account of improved early warning system, cyclone forecasting, better disaster management activities such as timely evacuation, rehabilitation and relief distribution. Now these are the areas that are very much important while you are writing mains examination. Such answer, such points will give you very good number of marks. Now what are those? The significant drop was on account of improved early warning system. What is early warning system? We have installed some of the equipment and machineries that are there in Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean, other parts of Indian Ocean. And here we are able to measure the changes that are causing. And then finally, the warning system, that the information dissemination also has effectively developed, that is through maybe online or maybe TV, radio, etc. And then the next thing is improved cyclone forecasting, that expecting the cyclone way ahead or well ahead, and better disaster management activities such as timely evacuation, rehabilitation and distribution of the food or maybe other articles that are necessary during the time of floods. Now these has helped to reduce the number of fatalities and effect. The Asian Development Bank's report in 2014 estimated India would suffer a loss of around 1.8% of annual GDP by 2050 from climate related events alone. That only because of the climatic only because of the climate activities or the climate disasters, India is going to lose almost 1.8% of its GDP by 2050. India lost around 2% of GDP and 15% of total revenue over 1999 to 2020, according to the Global Climate Risk Index report 2021. We may have to quote such examples. How to improve the number in the mains examination? By quoting such numbers, such facts and evidence-based writing. This is what is called evidence-based writing. And here it is the importance of the newspaper reading and analysis. Now here, India ranks 7th worst hit country globally in 2019 due to the frequent occurrence of extreme weather related events. Extreme weather related, that may be extreme cold or extreme hot. Due to this, there are maybe hot heat waves and people died because of that, or maybe disasters like cyclone, flood or drought. In the aftermath of 1919 super cyclone, the government of Odisha took up various cyclone mitigation measures, which included installing a disaster warning system in the coastal districts and construction of evacuation shelters in cyclone prone districts. Other steps were setting up of Odisha Disaster Management Authority, conducting regular cabinet meetings for the disaster preparedness, and building Odisha Disaster Rapid Action Force. These are the measures that has Odisha has taken because of its bad affected history. Now, there are essential steps to be taken. First one is cyclone warning system. As we have seen that early, because of early warning system only, we got the number reduced and impact also reduced over a period of time. Cyclone warning system and revamped disaster preparedness measures. The second thing is the government must widen the cover under shelter bed plantation. What is shelter bed plantation? Now, the cyclone is hitting badly on the coastal area because there are no tree cover that are along the coast. Let us assume this is the coast. If you have some tree cover over here, which are of salt tolerant, then the impact will be lesser. As the cyclone will come and reach, and the moment it reach here, that will be obstructing. The tree cover will be obstructing the cyclone speed so that it reduces the impact. But the cover is got affected because of the coastal development. Now, there are CRZ rules, coastal zone, like regulating zone is there, but these rules are not followed properly. And the mangroves also got affected. What are mangrove forests? Mangrove forest are the type of forest which are salt tolerant trees that are living in the coastal area under the salt water. Now, these roots of the trees will be floating in the water so that they will be breathing air from this. The roots of these mangrove trees are not just like the other trees that are deep inside the soil, but here these roots of the mangrove forest are floating on the water, and these are a very good insurance against the any calamity that is related with the cyclone or even the tsunami. These are the activities that will be safeguarded by the mangrove forest. Apart from that, mangroves are one of the most productive zones where that will be leading to good breeding zone for the fishing, and these are the productive zone for the food of the fish, etc. So we have to like safeguard these areas by, like, second is the government must widen the cover and shelter belt plantation and help regenerate mangroves in coastal region to lessen impact of cyclones. In addition, adapting cost-effective long-term mitigation measures, including building cyclone-resilient infrastructure such as constructing storm surge-resilient embankments. Now, the embankments are like where you will not be getting affected because of the floods. And canals and improving river connectivity so that there won't be, if there is a good connectivity of canals, then the flow of water will be smoothly flowed. Otherwise, that will be leading to clogging and submergence of the low-lying areas. Now, by improving the canals and embankments, connectivity will lead to prevent waterlogging in low-lying areas are important. The third, installing disaster-resilient power infrastructure. Whenever there is a disaster, then what is the first impact thing? The infrastructure. That is, utmost is a power infrastructure. Now, whenever there is no power, no connectivity is possible. If you are able to build any infrastructure that is resilient of this cyclone or disaster resilient, then that will be a great help and which can be has the potential to reduce even the further losses. And the other dimension for this, finally, health coordination between the center and state. Healthy coordination between the center and state is utmost important. Whenever there is losses occur by the state, then there may be urges to the center, but the center may not be responding timely because of a lack of funds or maybe whatever the other reasons. But it is necessary to safeguard our coastline, as we have almost 7500 kilometers of coastline from like Gujarat in the west to eastern side in the like Bengal in the eastern side. Now, there are western cyclones and eastern part cyclone, Arabian Sea and even the Bay of Bengal are leading to formation of cyclones. That's okay. What is meant by cyclone and what are the types of cyclone? Are the cyclones are forming only in the tropical region or even they are forming globally? And what are the different names? Let us try to look into this area. Cyclones are of two types, tropical cyclones and extratropical cyclones. What is meant by tropical cyclone? Tropical cyclone means the cyclones that are formed in between equator and the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. Now, all the cyclones that are formed in these areas are called tropical cyclones. Any cyclone that is forming beyond this are called the temperate cyclones or extratropical cyclones. Now let us try to understand what are the reasons for these. That what is a cyclone first of all? Cyclone is a type of weather phenomenon where low pressure area formed over the ocean due to the extreme heat or excess of heat. Now this low pressure center will attract the surrounding winds and which will be impacted by the Coriolis force. So that which will lead to the movement towards the coastal area. Now this is a center that is having the low pressure that may be of 960 millibar. Now let us say there is an isobar. What is an isobar? Isobar is a line that is drawn by joining all the points that are of equal pressure. Now wherever on this line you measure, there will be equal pressure. Now this line may be indicating 970 millibar and this line may be 980 and further it goes on. Now because of the Coriolis extreme heat and pressure is inversely proportional to temperature, whenever there is increase in pressure, the temperature decreases. Now from the below what happens, whenever there is a low pressure, the whirling effect will be guided and then this leads to evaporation of the water vapor from below. Now these two things will cause feeding the clouds above and then condensation happens. Now whenever this subjected to Coriolis force that moves towards the continents and whenever they reach the continent, sudden fall on the continent will lead to giving out all the or shed off all the moisture that it is containing within it and this lead to the impact, that is huge rain for over a period of at least 3 to 5 days on the same area, that leads to high speed of the winds coupled with the high amount of precipitation. Now there are tropical cyclones develop in the region between Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. They are large scale weather system developing over tropical or subtropical waters where they get organized into surface wind circulation. Now this surface extratropical cyclones occur in temperate zone and high latitude regions, though they are known for to originate in the polar region. The reason for this extratropical cyclones are different parameters. Here comes the fronts and air masses. What is an air mass? Air mass is a homogeneously developed temperature, water vapor or the moisture and pressure parameters. What are the parameters? Temperature of the air, pressure and the water vapor here or the humidity in this air is almost same. At a vast stretch of almost thousands of kilometers, this leads to acquiring the same properties on the ground or maybe on the ocean. Now here there are two types of air masses. One is cold air mass and the other is warm air mass. Now the warm air mass and cold air mass, as and when they move towards each other, when they come in contact with each other, as the cold air mass will be having more weight and the warm air mass will have the lesser weight, the warm air mass tries to tend to rise above the cold air mass and this led to the formation of clouds and further giving the water or the precipitation. This is all about the extratropical cyclones. Now anticyclones are the phenomenon where high pressure center will be created and which will be trying to give out all the air, and where does it give out the air? It will be feeding from the above. In the anticyclone phenomenon, you will not be having the rain or precipitation. An anticyclone is the opposite of cyclone, that is, it has an outward spiraling air circulation around a high pressure center. An anticyclone's wind rotate clockwise in northern hemisphere. A cyclone wind rotate anti-clockwise in the northern hemisphere. Anticyclone rotate in the clockwise in the northern hemisphere. In anticyclone, air comes from above and sinks to the ground. High pressure centers generally have fair weather. Now there are different names for the cyclones in the different areas. What are they? Let us try to. We call cyclones in the Indian Ocean region, tropical cyclone in the Indian Ocean region. But they are called typhoons, they are called different hurricanes and they are called here in Japan and China region, we call them as the typhoons. And in Gulf region of Caribbean, we call them as hurricanes. Here, tropical cyclones. Here also, willy-willies in the Australia. These are the different names that we call here in different regions. Thank you. Keep watching Adapt Solutions for the news analysis program. Add-on solutions. Add-on desires.